The answer is the second choice, that she can almost recover the full message, everything except for the very first block, that the point of the initialization vector is just to hide repetition among encryptions that would appear just looking at the first block. And the reason for this, we can look at how the encryption mode behaves. We saw that for all the blocks except for the first one, the value of CI is the encryption of the value MI, include my key there. And we saw for the way the encryption mode works, CI is equal to the encryption using the key K of MI XOR CI negative 1. The exception to that is block C0, where that's the value of encrypting M0 XORed with the IV. So we didn't explain how to do decryption, but from the way the encryption was, you should be able to figure that out. We can look at this backwards. So in order to get the last message block, well, what we need to do is decrypt using key K. And the input to decrypt is this last ciphertext block. So we're going backwards. We're decrypting. We don't have the message block yet. To get the message block, we need to do the XOR to get message block N minus 1. And so that means we're XORing that with the ciphertext value of the previous block, which we already have, right? Remember, we have to decrypt, we start with all the ciphertext blocks. So this is how we decrypted the last block, but each block is the same. To get message block I, we need to decrypt ciphertext block I and XOR that with the previous ciphertext block. So we can do that for all the blocks, except for we have this exception for the last one. The encryption for the last one used this IV. To get the last message block, well, what we need to do is decrypt the last ciphertext block, or the first ciphertext block, we're going backwards now, and then XOR that result with the IV. So if we lose the IV, but don't lose the key and don't lose the ciphertext, we've lost just the first block. And if the IV was selected perfectly at random, well, we have no information at all about the first block, because whatever we get out of this decryption is XORed with that IV to get the message. So if we have no information about the IV, we have no information about the first message block, but we can decrypt all the other blocks.